Thank you. Welcome to the Srimad Bhagavatam conference call. Today we are very fortunate to have His Grace Rasraj Gopal prabhuji to enlighten us on Srimad Bhagavatam. Prabhuji, are you present on the call?
Am I audible?
Yes, Hare Krishna Prabhuji. Please accept the humble obeisances. All the best to Srila Prabhupada and Gurudev.
Yes, oh, thank you.
Thank you so much, Prabhuji, for giving a valuable association and time. So now I would like to hand over the call to you, Prabhuji. Thank you so much, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskritya Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Saraswatim Vyasam Tato Jayam Udirayet Nashtaprayeshu Abhadreshu Nityam Bhagavate Sevaya Bhagavate Uttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishthiki Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devaki Nandanaya Cha Nanda Gopa Kumaraya Govindaya Namo Namaha Namaha Pankajanabhaya Namaha Pankajamalini Namaha Pankajanetraya Namaste Pankajanghaye Hare Krishna. A very good Hare Krishna to all, everybody. I offer my humble obeisances at the lotus feet of my Gurudev, Srila Prabhupada, all the assembled devotees who are connected to this call, conference call. I express my gratitude and thanks from the core of my heart for giving me the opportunity to serve all the exalted Vaishnavas like you. So we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 4, Creation of the Fourth Order, text number 53. 424 chapter is chanting the song sung by Lord Shiva. Text 53.
Etadarupam anudheyam atma shuddhim abhipsatam yadbhakti yogo bhayadah swadharmam anutishthatam etadrupam anudheyam Atma Shuddhim Abhipsatam Yad Bhakti Yogo Bhayadaha Swadharmam Anutishthatam.
The translation and purpose by His Divine Grace Abhay Charanarvind Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Translation. My dear Lord, those who desire to purify their existence must always engage in meditation upon your lotus feet, as described above. Those who are serious about executing their occupational duties and who want freedom from fear must take to this process of bhakti yoga. Purport. It is said that the transcendental name, form, pastimes and entourage of the Lord cannot be appreciated by the blunt material senses. Therefore, one has to engage himself in devotional service so that the senses may be purified and one can see the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Here, however, it is indicated that those who are constantly engaged in meditating on the lotus feet of the Lord are certainly purified of the material contamination of the senses and are thus able to see the Supreme Lord face to face. The word meditation is very popular in this age amongst the common people, but they do not know the actual meaning of meditation. However, from Vedic literature, we learn that the yogis are always absorbed in meditation. upon the lotus feet of the Lord. Dhyanavasthita tadgatena manasa pashyanti yam yoginah. Bhagavatam 12.13.1. This is the real business of the yogis, to think of the lotus feet of the Lord. Lord Shiva therefore advises that one who is actually serious about purification must engage himself in this type of meditation or in the mystic yoga system, which will help him not only to see the Lord within constantly, but to see him face to face and become his associate in Vaikuntha Loka or Goloka Vrindavan. The word Swadharmam, as in Swadharmam Anutishthatam, indicates that the system of Varnashrama, which indicates the occupational duties of the Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra, and which is the perfect institution for humanity, must be supported by Bhakti Yoga if one at all wants security in life. Generally, people think that simply by executing the occupational duties of a Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya or Shudra, or the duty of a Brahmachari, Grahastha, Vanaprastha or Sannyasi, one becomes fearless or securely attains liberation. But factually, unless all these occupational duties are accompanied by Bhakti Yoga, one cannot become fearless. In Bhagavad Gita, there are descriptions of Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Dhyana Yoga, etc. But unless one comes to the point of Bhakti Yoga, these other yogas cannot help one attain the highest perfection of life. In other words, Bhakti Yoga is the only means for liberation. We find this conclusion also in Chaitanya Charitamrita, in a discussion between Lord Chaitanya and Ramananda Rai regarding a human being's liberation from this material world. In that discussion, Ramananda Rai referred to the execution of Varnashrama Dharma, and Lord Chaitanya indicated that Varnashrama Dharma was simply external, eho bahya. Lord Chaitanya wanted to impress upon Ramananda Rai that simply by executing the duties of Varnashrama Dharma, one is not guaranteed liberation. Finally, Ramananda Rai referred to the process of Bhakti Yoga. Thane sthitah shruti gatam tanuvan manobhi, Bhagavatam 10.14.3. Regardless of one's condition of life, if he practices Bhakti Yoga, which begins with hearing shruti gatam, the transcendental messages of the Lord through the mouths of devotees, he gradually conquers the unconquerable God. God is known to be unconquerable, but one who submissively hears the words of a self-realized soul conquers the unconquerable. The conclusion is that if one is serious about liberation, he not only should execute the occupational duties of Varnashrama Dharma, but should also engage in Bhakti Yoga by beginning hearing from a realized soul. This process will help the devotee conquer the unconquerable Supreme Personality of Godhead and become his associate after giving up the material body. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Sri Chaitanya Mano Abhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeyaham Sri Guruh Sri Yuta Padakamalam Sri Gurum Vaishnavamscha Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sadivam Tatvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhan Vitamscha Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute
Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaur Bhaktavrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 4:24:53 So here we are referring to the songs sung by none other than Lord Shiva. There is one song which is sung by Lord Krishna, and that we call as Gita of Bhagavat, Bhagavan, that is Bhagavad Gita. Srimad Bhagavad Gita is a song sung by Krishna, and it is our law book. And here Shiva is happily, very happy, very pleased with the devotional service of the Prachetas, the sons of Prachina Bari. In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says in the fourth chapter, Ajo api sannave atma Bhutanam Ishwaro Apisan Prakritim Swam Adhishthaya Sambhavami Atma Mayaya Sambhavami Atma Mayaya. So Krishna says, Ajo Api San Ave, Ajo Api, I am unborn, Ajo, Ajanma. Ajo Api, I am unborn. Yet I take birth. Sun away atma, and even though I am undestroyable. See, I am unborn and I am undestroyable. So if I am undestroyable, how I can take birth? It's a $1 million question. In fact, this tattva is called Achintya Bhedabhed tattva, as explained by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Krishna says, I am unborn, yet, and also I am undestroyable, avyayatma, ajo api san avyayatma. And third quality of Krishna, he himself says that I am Ishwara among all the living entities. Bhutanam Ishwaro api san. Yet, what I do is, prakritim swam, with the help of my own prakriti, by nature, I have different natures, so I take their support. Prakrityam swam adishthaya sambhavami, I take birth. Atma mayaya, with my own maya. I do not take help from anybody else for taking birth in this material world. So that is why he is God. That is why he is unconquerable God. And Shiva here, when he is explaining the characters and qualities of Lord Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, in the earlier chapters, he is mentioning how that Lord is visible, what is the form of the Lord. And with the earlier chapters, Lord Shiva clearly clarifies all these Mayavadis and all the other forms of people who are worshipping different forms, who say that Lord does not have any form, or the God has no form. And he clearly vanquishes all their thoughts and philosophies about Supreme Personality of Godhead by explaining how Krishna's form is so beautiful right from his lotus feet, the toenails of the lotus feet, and gradually going upwards towards his knees, towards his thighs, waist, navel, stomach,
chest, face, eyes, and you know, create a kundalam, and slowly we can see how beautiful, how marvelous, how wonderful is the form of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is so beautiful, his smile is so beautiful, everything about him is lotus, everything about him is sweet, madhuram, madhuram, adharam, madhuram, absolutely sweet and absolutely beautiful. This is how Lord Shiva himself explains. In fact, when Lord Shiva is always seen as a meditating person. So, Bhavani, Shiva is Bhava, and Bhavani, she asks, whom are you meditating upon? Always I've seen you, that you are always in meditation, dhyana avasthita. Whom are you meditating upon? And Shiva explains, or answers, replies, he says, Ram Ram Rameti Rame Rame Mano Rame Sahasranam Tatulyam Ram Ram Varadare Ram Ram Rameti. So he is meditating upon that beautiful form of Prabhu Ramachandra, Shri Ram. When you say Shri Ram, Shri Ram, Shri Ramachandra Kripalu Bhajamana Aranabhava Bhaya Darunam Nava Kanjalochana. Kanjalochana means lotus feet. Nava Kanjalochana. Lochana is eyes. Lochana Kanjamukhakara Kanjapada Kanjarunam. So that everything about Prabhu Ramachandra is lotus. That is Kamala Nayana, Kamala Charana. So when we speak about such forms of, beautiful forms of Krishna, or we say Mahavishnu with yellow pitambari and the three vatsa and Kaustubha Mani and the beautiful broad shoulders, Lakshmi Devi sitting on the chest and beautiful smiling face and that kataksha glances of Mahavishnu, the golden kirit embedded with diamonds and all types of pearls and rubies and emeralds. It's such a beautiful form of Krishna. One has to meditate upon this form always in our mind, in between our eyebrows. Sixth chapter ends. Sixth chapter in Bhagavad Gita is Dhyana Yoga. And that ends, the chapter ends with Krishna saying, Yoginam api sarvesham madgaten antaratmana saddhavan bhajate yomam same yukta tamomata Yoginam api sarvesham madgaten antaratmana. Among all the types of yogis so far I have explained you, Yoginam api sarvesham madgaten antaratmana, one who meditates upon me in his mind, madgaten antaratmana, and with full faith, shraddhavan bhajate yo mam, with full faith who worships me, same yukta tamo mata, he is the supreme among all the yogis, he is the best of all the yogis. So whatsoever type of yogas we opt for in this material world, it's very difficult for people to accept bhakti yoga. In this chapter also, Krishna, Shiva says that one who wants freedom from fear must take to this process of bhakti yoga. People do not generally come or get attracted to, or you know, they don't like this bhakti yoga process. What is bhakti yoga? Bhakti yoga is nothing but just chant Krishna's names. Just chant Lord's names. And it's very difficult. This is just so simple. If you tell people that you can achieve God by chanting his holy names, people say, oh, he is supreme God. And it's not so easy to get his mercy. If you want his mercy,
you need some complicated process. You need some complex process to make it more complicated. They don't like simple things, because people feel that complicated thing is better than simpler process. If anything is simple, it has no use, or it has no value. In fact, Bhakti Yoga is the most difficult process among everything. Chanting of Lord's name is not so easy. We have been told, we have been taught, we have been explained in so many satsangas by so many acharyas, so many kirtans, and so many occasions, that chant Lord Krishna's name and be happy. Yet, it is very difficult for us to chant. The acharyas say that you have to chant minimum 16 rounds daily. But is it easy? Is it that easy? We, especially with the grahasthas, find it extremely difficult to chant 16 rounds continuously. It is not only chanting. It is called aparadha rahita chanting. That is quality chanting. One needs to chant the holy names of the Lord without any aparadha. But that is very difficult again. We are compelled to commit aparadhas, offenses. We speak about 10 offenses. But the first offense is Vaishnava aparadha. Because that is the topmost aparadha. Just like when we say, which is the topmost seva among different types of sevas, prasad distribution, kitchen activities, worshipping the deity worship, or shingar. There are so many, plenty of sevas in the temple and at home itself. Which is the topmost seva? The topmost seva is Vaishnava seva. You have to serve a Vaishnava who is a strong devotee of Krishna. Just serve him. That is the topmost seva. And similarly, exactly on the similar grounds, the topmost aparadha is also Vaishnava aparadha. And one is committed to Vaishnava aparadha either by any means, kayena, vacha, manasa, by any means. We unfortunately, unwillingly, are compelled to commit the Vaishnava aparadha. So let us come back to the topic of Krishna's forms. Here in this chapter, Lord Shiva gives that beautiful form of the explains so beautifully the form of Lord Vishnu. But have we ever wondered that where there are few other forms on which one can meditate upon also, but it's very difficult? Let us take some forms of Lord Vishnu which are very difficult to be meditated upon. In Dashavatara, there is the first shloka, it says, Pralaya payodhi jale dhratamanasi vedam vihita vahitra charitam akhedam keshavadhrita Meena Sharira, Keshavadrita, Meena Sharira, Jaya Jagadish Hare, Jaya Jagadish Hare, Jaya Jagadish Hare, Ah, Jaya Jagadish Hare. I normally go for preaching in Ratnagiri, which is on the Konkan coastal area.
And the staple food of Konkan people is fish. So, just before leaving for Ratnagiri, a couple of days back, I was discussing with my colleagues here. And in the discussion, I just explained them that, yes, next week I am going to Ratnagiri for teaching, for counseling. And this devotee, of friend of mine, he was surprised. And he said, oh, Prabhuji, it's very difficult for the coastal people, Konkans, Konkanis, to come to devotional service. And I was wondering, how did he react like this? Why? Then I realized, yes, because the staple food of coastal people is fish, and one just cannot live without fish. Just like a fish cannot live without water, these people cannot live without fish. So it is like that. But I was surprised, and also I was happy that there are more than 300 to 400 devotees in this congregation who are very serious in the Ratnagiri, Rajapur and the Konkan belt zone, who have accepted this form of devotional service propagated by Srila Prabhupada, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Acharyas. They have accepted it very pleasingly, and they are doing it very much, they are doing a very wonderful service in that belt. So it is really wonderful. So when we say fish, you can see Krishna takes that form of a fish. It is explained in Srimad Bhagavatam in the 9th canto that during the end of Yuga, that is called the Pralaya Samay, there is a king called Satyavrata. And he goes at the banks of river Kritamala, and there he offers Arghya. So he goes for bathing in early in the morning as usual, and after bathing he starts offering Arghya. So he just lifts a cup of water like this, and when he lifts the water in his two palms, he finds a small fish on it. In water as well as small fish, very tiny fish in his both hands. And he looks at that fish, and that fish says, he was about to throw that fish in that river back again. The fish started speaking. Fish says, hey Rajan, you are the protector of all living beings. Why are you putting me back into the river? You protect me. I am a very small fish. There are so many large fishes who will eat me up. So please protect me. And the king, as usual, he sympathizes and he puts the fish in his kamandalu, takes that fish home and places that fish in a small tank, you know, let us call it a glass tank. Like nowadays we have aquarium, a small aquarium in our houses, something similar to that. He places that fish in that glass tank and very nicely spends that day. Next morning when he wakes up and comes and finds that tank in his hall, he finds that the fish has grown. The fish has grown to an extent that his head was touching one side of the glass and his tail was touching on the other side of the tank. And he was finding it very difficult to adjust. And he was calling, Rajan, Rajan. The king came down there and he saw, he was wondered, he was awestruck. What is this? He says, Rajan, Rajan, I am not comfortable here. See, I cannot move. Please place me in a better area, in a comfortable zone. Please remove me from this place and put me in a bigger place. And Raja Satyavrata, King Satyavrata, he lifts that fish from there and there is a small pond, you know, outside his veranda. He places that fish in the pond and leaves it. And the next morning, to his greater surprise, he finds that the fish has grown further big. A huge fish, he has grown further. And he is feeling uncomfortable. Again, he was struggling. He said, Rajan, look, I have grown bigger. My body has grown bigger. I am uncomfortable here. Please remove me from this place and place me some other place, some other bigger space. Now, that king was really surprised. What is this happening? Still, he took the fish somehow and further went downwards. He found a huge well, you know, very big well. And he slowly pushed him in that well. And the fish was comfortable there. The well was sufficiently large enough that this fish was moving very nicely and comfortably and enjoying. The king thought, well, now the story might end here. That's it. He left for his job, and the next morning when he woke up, and to his surprise, he started hearing the word, Rajan, please come here. Please help me out. He went to the well and he found that the fish has grown further bigger. And now he cannot hold it. He really understood that this fish is not an ordinary fish. This fish is not an ordinary fish. He said, hey fish, tell me literally who you are. Who are you? In one day, if you are able to expand into soaps such a huge body, you are not an ordinary fish. You are some demigod or some incarnation. Please explain me. And then the king was actually a devotee of the Lord. And when a devotee of the Lord then clearly understands the position, he is empowered by Lord, that he can understand the situation. Therefore, it's very important for us to take this chanting so seriously and become a devotee of the Lord, so that we are empowered to understand the situation around us. You know, now the biggest worry for us is nothing but the corona. Now everywhere, wherever we go, people talk only one topic. People are discussing only one issue. Anywhere we go, anywhere in the society, in the office, in the school, in the college, in the business place, anywhere. Internet, news, radio, TV, anywhere if you go, there is only one topic of discussion, and that is corona. It has become like this big fish. The corona disease has become so big that it has literally covered the entire gamut of the world, one end, from one end to the other end. It is not only confined to China or to some one particular country or one particular village state. No, it has affected US, it's affecting India now. Indian government is trying to do lots of things to restrict the loss to a minimum as possible. But there is a catch there. Srila Prabhupada, when he was in this peak of his preaching Krishna consciousness, during that period, there was a plague in India, in Surat or somewhere in that region. And people were asked, there was a complete lockdown. The government has ordered lockdown. Nobody should come out because plague has become epidemic. It was pandemic or whatever you call it. And people were literally afraid. There was no medicine on plague. and it was death everywhere. And in such, during such occasion, Srila Prabhupada comes out with few of his disciples, and in those lanes he starts Sankirtan. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So there was chanting Sankirtana of Hare Krishna, and people were hearing from inside, but nobody dared to come out. But Srila Prabhupada was an empowered soul by Lord. He was understanding the situation, and he knew that to overcome such a big problem, such a big, huge, monstrous problem, if you want to overcome, you can do it only by Lord's holy names, chanting Holy Lord's holy names, chanting Krishna's holy names. He was so comfortable with it, and literally the plague ended there by the Sankirtana, Hare Krishna. So we also, as aspiring devotees, as struggling devotees, we are trying to become Shuddha Bhaktas. We are aspiring, but yet we should have the conviction, and we can chant at home seriously. Now is the time to take this chanting seriously. There's a lecture by Sarvabhauma Prabhu. He says, you chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Because Krishna says, if one chants my name and leaves the body, then he is entitled to come back to my place. Antakale cha mamaiva smaran muktva kalevaram yaha prayati sa mad bhavam yati nastatra samshayaha. So there is absolutely no doubt that if one remembers me at a time of death, he is sure to come to my place. Antakale cha mameva smaran muktva kalevaram. When he leaves the body, muktva kalevaram, mameva smaran, remembering me only, then that's how. That is why we are doing the Sankirtana. So when we are doing Sankirtana continuously, and if Corona comes, then what happens is, Corona will have to cover his face with his mask. Understood? The coronavirus, he has to buy some virus mask from the market, from his own market, and put a mask on his face and rush. He cannot attack devotees. Because Krishna says, if one remembers me and leaves the body, if coronavirus attacks and if you are to die, then we will remember Krishna's name and die. We will leave the body. That means we will go to Goloka. But unfortunately, we are not qualified to Goloka. Understood? We are not qualified to go to Goloka. So coronavirus cannot kill us. So we have to chant. There you go. What a beautiful theory. And that is true. We are absolutely not yet qualified to go to Goloka. Whatever, howsoever we will feel that, no, I am such a huge, such a wonderful devotee, I am everything sincere in all my things and all blah, blah, blah. No, nothing, absolutely nothing. Because we are only talking about this birth. We are totally ignorant. We have no knowledge about our earlier births, what we have done, how many sins we have committed. We are absolutely unaware. So we are definitely not qualified to go to Goloka. And if you are keep continuously chanting, Corona is there, that virus cannot come and kill us. So we are free. We are safe. So therefore, Krishna takes the form of Matsya. Matsya Rupi Narayana Saptahita Garadundishi Vedanele Choruni Brahma Anuniya Deshi. So there is another fact about Matsya Rupa, where Krishna actually takes the form of Matsya to bring back the Vedas which were stolen by a demon called Hayagriva. Krishna takes the form of fish, Matsya Rupa, and saves the Vedas. So it is there in the Srimad Bhagavatam 9th canto. So this is, and how is the form of the fish? Satyavrat Muni, when he says that, tells to that fish, "Hey fish, please let me know, who are you? How, why are you taking such a huge form? What exactly is the reason?" Krishna says in the Gita, he says, "Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutanam adharmasya tadatmanam shujamyaham paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha dushkritam dharma sansthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge sambhavami yuge yuge." So again here the word comes, sambhavami, which means he takes birth. And so most important fact about his taking birth is paritranaya sadhunam, that is to save the devotees. Here lies the catch. Paritranaya sadhunam, that means to save the devotees, is his first priority. Vinashaya cha dushkratam, and to kill the shatrus or the durjanas or the evil. So that is secondary. That comes as a second part of the sentence or the line of the verse. But paritranaya is important. So here now the situation we all are in, a very, very dangerous situation due to this particular virus. And my sincere and humble request to the entire devotee world on this planet is that let us take at least now very seriously for chanting the holy mantras, for chanting the holy names of Lord Krishna, which has given to us by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu in this yuga. And he says, please take this mantra, please chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So easy. 16 worded Baha mantra, there is nothing else to be done. There is no complex geometry, trigonometry, geography, history, civics, any subject to be understood, nothing, nothing, nothing at all. Only our lip movement from the mouth and say, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, Krishna. So I hope I am audible. I hope I am audible. And so, the king Satyavrat, he tells.
Yes, we can hear you, Prabhu.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Unfortunately, there's some issue with my one second. I'm just adjusting. Yeah. So, the king Satyavrat Muni, not Satyavrat Muni, the king Satyavrat, he requests, he understands that it is none other than Lord Vishnu who has come in the form of, in the incarnation of this Matsya Rupa. And he says, I know you are none other than that Supreme Lord Vishnu. Please tell me, please, please tell me, what is the reason for this? See, Satyavrata king, he is not aware of the future. But Lord is aware of everything. We know that. Nattvam vekta parantapa. You do not understand the future, but I know I know everything. So he asks, why are you have you taken this incarnation? And that time Mahavishnu explains to him and says, just another 7 days from now, there is going to be huge, heavy rainfall. And it is not a rainfall, it will basically pour down torrents. It will be torrential rainfall. And those rains will come from the torrential clouds of those clouds which come during the pralaya, that is the destruction of the yuga, destruction of this planet, when there is a transition from Satya Yuga to Treta or Treta to Dwapar, when Brahma sleeps or Brahma awakes. So there are small pralayas and bigger pralayas, there are various pralayas. So Vishnuji explains that in next coming seventh day, this world will be coming to an end because of the transition of the yuga, and so there will be tremendous thunder, torrential rain, and within fraction of minutes, seconds, the complete planet will be flooded underwater. The entire your country will be flooded and completely underwater. The complete planet, the whole planet will be underwater. And during that period, you make a boat. He says, he will also arrange for a boat. The fish, that means Matsya Avatar, Krishna says, ki I will arrange for a boat as well. And you have to take the medicinal herbs some seeds, then some living entities and some good souls. You know, there will be some brahmanas, rishi munis and lots of good souls who are in your region. Please take them in that boat, and when you have to tie this boat by none other than you take the help of, there will be no rope. Vasuki will become the rope. So with the help of Vasuki, you tie one end to the boat and other end on the horn of my mouth. So there will be a single horn, that fish will have a horn. And tie it, and then I will guide you all very smoothly, help you all to come out of this menace, this thunder power, torrential rain power, this flooding. I will help you out, and that is why I have taken this bath. Hare Krishna. So again, here if you see, there's the only reason for taking form of Matsya Avatar is Paritranaya Sadhunam. So here he is not Vinashaya to Dushpratam part does not come. You see only the Paritranaya Sadhunam. But again, when Shiva explains the forms of Lord Vishnu with Pitambari and four shoulders and Chaturbhuja with Shankh Chakra Gada Padma in his hands. And here we see that Lord Krishna takes the form of a fish, a beautiful fish, which is normally a staple food of many people in and around the globe. In fact, in China, there is not a single animal which is left which people don't eat. And that is why this has been created. Such a big menace was created only pure because of that reason. So therefore, this is one of the avatars, incarnations, where Krishna takes in the Satya Yuga. We normally discuss about 10 avatars of Lord. There are more than 23, 24 avatars actually described in Puranas. In fact, there are umpteen. But prominently, 24 are there in the Srimad Bhagavatam. And out of that, even 10 are predominantly being discussed. So the first one is this Matsya Avatar which we discussed. So in Satya Yuga, out of these 10 avatars, normally there are 6 incarnations which are discussed in this Dashavatara of Shakti Yuga. The next incarnation, when we see, when we discuss about Krishna, this Krishna takes a form, he takes the form of a tortoise, Kurma. Now, what is the significance of Kurma? We see that there is a battle between Asuras and demigods. In Satyuga, they were in different planets and they were fighting each other. In Treta Yuga, they were in different countries. They were in different countries. One is in Ayodhya in India and other is in Sri Lanka. In Dwapar, they were in the same country, in the same house. In Kali Yuga, they are in the same body. The demons and the devatas, demigods and demons are both in the same body. So here in Shakti Yuga, there was a fight between demons and demigods, and this time the fight was such that they both were powerful and both were exhausted, both were extremely tired, and the demigods rushed to Krishna and said, please help us, what should you do? We are losing the battle. We have not lost the battle, but we are very much tired now. And at that time, even the daityas or the asuras, they were also tired. So Krishna takes different stances at different times, depending upon the time, place and circumstance. So this time, Krishna told the demigods, what you do is you sign a treaty with asuras. I have an idea for you. I have a task for you. You both of the come together, the asuras and the demigods come together for a project. And what is that project? That you have to churn the ocean. That ocean, when you are churning, there will be lots of things which will come out from the churning of the ocean. And the ultimate thing which is coming, which is a product of the churning, will be Amrita Kumbha, the Kalash, or the Amrita Kalash. So you take that Amrita, you become very strong, you become immortal, and then you can defeat the Asuras. That was what the plan was. But for this task, you cannot do it single-handedly. You need the help of the Asuras. And Asuras and demigods, both of them come together, and they say, you have to take Mandar Parvat. Mandar Parvat as a churning rod. Place it in the ocean and take again Vasuki as a rope to churn the ocean with the help of the Mandar Parvat. Now when they started this project, the Asuras and the demons both towards both the end of the snake and Mandar Parvat in between coiled by the snake, and as they started the churning, because that Parvat was very huge, it started shaking on both the sides, and instead of the churning was not happening smoothly as required. And again the demigods, they rushed, they prayed to Lord Krishna, "Hey Krishna, you told us to churn the ocean, but here we find that this hill, this Mandar Parvat is not steady, is not stable. Please help." So here we see that every time demigods, when they fall in trouble, they rush to Lord Krishna. So this is the characteristics of a devotee. A devotee who has taken shelter of Guru and Gauranga always runs to the Lord Gauranga at the time of difficulty. So let us pray to Gauranga Nityananda, please help us in these terrible times of this corona thing, and help us to remain fit and healthy. Oh Lord Gauranga, please help us to remain fit and healthy, so that we do not we continue in your mission of preaching Lord's holy names so that we are fit and healthy and we survive. We survive this crisis and we continue our mission of Srila Prabhupada's mission, serving Srila Prabhupada, serving Srila Guru, serving Gauranga by preaching, by the way of preaching, by way of our own sadhana. So the demigods rushed to Krishna and Krishna said, don't worry, I will ensure that this hill remains steady and you know it's you can smoothly churn the ocean. And Krishna takes the form of a tortoise, kachapa, that is called kurma. Krishna takes form of the kurma and he goes below the Mandar Parvat and holds the parvat very firmly. And there is the hill is very firmly stable, like a churning rod. And both the demigods and the daityas, the asuras, they are churning very nicely. In the process, Krishna wanted some massages on his back. He wanted few scratching also on his back. And it is for this purpose that Krishna was enjoying when the hill, the Mandar Parvat was getting churned, moved to and fro, he was scratching Lord's back. So nice. So nice. So that is how Krishna gets his things done. We cannot imagine, one cannot visualize what else. If you want to have our back scratched, then we'll have to apply some butter to some people, some of our relatives, and tell, please help me out. But here Krishna does in his own way. And Krishna takes the form of a tortoise, kachapa, kurma. Shiva tells us the beautiful form of Lord Vishnu Krishna with yellow pitambari and his four arms and all those things. But here we find that Krishna has taken form. First we have seen that he takes the form of a fish and now he takes form of a kurma, tortoise. And it's beyond our imagination. It's wonderful. Only Krishna can do that. And that is why he is called as God. Or that is why he is called as Supreme Personality of Godhead, who can do anything, anything at any time, at any place, under any circumstances. He can help us. He only can help us from this coronavirus by when he takes birth as Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Kali Yuga. He gives us the Karuna Rasa. He gives us the Karuna Rasa. Let us take the help of this Karuna Rasa in defeating coronavirus. We have in the Satya Yuga, you can see the next form which he takes again, unbelievably, the form of a Sukar, boar incarnation, Varaha avatar. Krishna takes form of a Varaha. Why? Because Hiranyaksha has taken the earth. He was so powerful, Hiranyaksha, Jaya and Vijaya. He took the entire earth to his home in the ocean and to help the planet Earth come out and re-establish it in its proper orbit again back. Krishna had to take form of Varaha, boar incarnation. And such a beautiful incarnation. One can never imagine. Pig, sometimes we call it as a pig also. Sometimes hog also. Some people call it boar. Again, if we speak about pigs, they are staple food of some people in some countries. But
mistake me, do not mistake me, Krishna takes the form of a pig, boar. So do not eat any non-vegetarian, no fish, no boar, nothing, no pigs, no horse, no dogs, no cats. In China, they eat all the animals. You name any single animal that will be eaten, consumed by these people. That's what I've heard. In Wuhan market, they keep these animal livestock. If somebody comes, some customers come and they say, I want this, then they cut it live directly, take it and they start eating live directly without any cooking and all. I don't know. It may not be true, it may be true. But if it has come, I mean there is some truth in it. But that is very bad. Because human beings are supposed to eat pure vegetarian, pure vegetable food. We are not supposed to eat animals. Absolutely not. Human system is not, digestive system is not for consumption of non-vegetarian food. Well, that is a different subject, but that is it. Krishna is there. He takes the form of a boar and saves planet Earth, Varaha Avatar. And in the fifth incarnation, we see Krishna becomes a small dwarf Brahmana. Pachave avatar balicha dwara la dashi. Bhikshe salamaguni balila patala nishi. It is said. Pachave avatar balicha dwara la dashi. Bhikshe salamaguni balila patala nishi. सर्व समर्पण केले म्हणूनी प्रसन्न त्या होशी पाचवे. सो दॅट इज हाऊ कृष्णा बिकम्स अ द्वार बामणा बटुक वामन ही सेड अँड ही कम्स टू बली महाराज अँड टू रिलीव इंद्रा अगेन टू सेव्ह डेमिगॉड्स टू प्रोटेक्ट द डेमिगॉड्स टू प्रोटेक्ट इंद्रास टू प्रोटेक्ट देवतास टू प्रोटेक्ट द डिवाईन क्वालिटीज. Krishna approaches Bali Maharaja and begs, I want only 3 footsteps.
Chalayasi vikramane balim adbhutamaman.
In the Shavatara Stotra written by Jaidev Goswami, here is another verse which speaks about the Vamana Avatara.
Chalayasi vikramane बलिम अद्भुत मामन पदन खनीर जनित जन पावन पदन खनीर जनित जन पावन केशव धृता वामन रूपा जय जगदीश हरे जय जगदीश हरे जय जगदीश हरे जय जगदीश हरे.
छलयसी विक्रमणे बलिन बाय चीटिंग छलयसी विक्रमणे त्रिविक्रम इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज त्रिविक्रम बलिम अद्भुत वामन वंडरफुल अनबिलीवेबल अनइमॅजिनेबल अविश्वसनीय अद्भुत अकल्पनीय वामन. What he did, he just asked for 3 footsteps. Bali Maharaj said, you ask hundreds of acres of land, you ask for hundreds and tons of gold, silver, diamond, rubles, whatever else you want, you ask cows, elephants, horses, lands, buildings, maid servants, anything else you want. Please ask, I have plenty I can give you. How do you are asking just 3 footsteps of land? Only 3 steps of land? Chalayasi vikramane balim adbhutavaman. Krishna, Shukracharya was sitting beside him. Shukracharya, a very dangerous person. But again, these are all Krishna's pastimes. Krishna has nominated these characters. And they had given certain roles. Shukracharya advised Bali Maharaj and said, don't. Bali said, Tathastu, I'm giving you 3 steps of land. That is nothing for me. I give you, done.
Besides that, you ask anything more else? Lord said, no, I don't want anything else. I just want 3 footsteps of land. And Bali Maharaj said, done, given. Yes, that has to. Shukracharya says, no, stop. Bali Maharaj said, I am a Kshatriya. I stick to my word. The word that I have given is never fallible. I have given him word. I have promised him. And Shukracharya says, person can speak lies in 5 circumstances. Maybe I will not discuss this now in this class, but our important topic is Vamana Dev, when he starts taking the 3 steps of land, as soon as he starts taking the steps of land, the first step when he takes, he grows huge, gigantic, takes a huge, gigantic form. And in the first step, he takes a patala. And in the second step, when he lifts it up like this, we are situated in an egg. See, we all are in one egg. Egg means under. In Marathi or Hindi, it is under. Sanskrit also under. This is Brahmand. It is called Brahmand. So we all are situated in one egg, Brahmand. That is all these 3 lokas. The Patal loka, Bhu loka and Bhuvar loka. Swarga loka. So all these 3 lokas or the 14 lokas, 14 planets, this is in one Brahmand. So when Krishna stretches for the second step, is put upwards, zoom, when it goes up, it breaks the topmost shell of that egg, this Brahmanda, by his toenails, and outside this Brahmanda was Srimati Ganga Devi. Ganga Maya was outside this Brahmanda. She was existing there. Till that time, she had not entered earth planet. So as soon as Krishna pierced and broke the small shell of that Brahmanda, Ganga Maya touched Krishna's nails and she started pouring inside in the Brahmanda. She came to India. She came on this planet. Ganga, that's how Ganga was born. Then there is a story of Bhagiratha Muni and Lord Shiva, how he opened his jatas and conquered Ganga Devi. That's a different class which we can speak about. But here is the shloka where Jayadeva Goswami mentions, Chalayasi Vikramane Balim Adbhuta Vaman Padanakha Neera Janita Jana Pavan. Padanakha, the nail of the toes. Neera, Ganga Nadi, Janita Jana Pavan. That's how Ganga started flowing in this Brahmanda. Hare Krishna. Such a beautiful incarnation of Vamandev. And with all these forms of Lord Vishnu, we can discuss umpteen number of forms of Krishna and discuss and meditate upon and think upon and glorify Lord Vishnu and say, hey Krishna, you are such a wonderful person, you are such a beautiful person, you are such a magnificent, munificent person, you are all pervading, you have a full, so beautiful form, your glances are so beautiful, you are so attractive, all attractive. Please, please, please give me shelter. I take shelter of your lotus feet. And please give me your shelter. And please give me your blessings. And please give me your blessings so that I serve your loving devotees. So that I get an opportunity to serve your devotees. To serve devotees of your devotees. As in the mood of Das Dasa Nidhas. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. I give a stop for today's subject here. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Thank you so much, Prabhuji, for such a beautiful, beautiful class, beautiful verses. So thank you, Prabhuji. We relish a lot. Thank you so much. So now I will request devotees, if they have any question or comments for Prabhuji, they can ask now.
Yes.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much, Prabhu. Such a beautiful class. Very nice Titi darshan of your Lord, Prabhu, your altar. Thank you so much. And very beautiful singing, Prabhu. And I really like the point that you are making about Corona will keep a mask and run away. Who by the Hari comes, it will run away, Prabhu. Thank you, Prabhu, for such a beautiful class.
Hari Bol. Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Hari Bol.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji, Dandat Pranam,
Algorist.
So, Prabhuji, very, very beautiful class and very nice singing, Prabhuji. So, Prabhuji, when you go to Ratnagiri, how do you encourage the people there for not to eat fish?
Yes. See, basically, it is purely by Nama Sankirtana. In fact, we are not the doers. Neither me or, for that matter, anybody of us, we are not doers. Everything is done by the holy Nam. When we do Nagar Sankirtan along the roads of Ratnagiri, when we go for preaching, people get attracted to the Nama Sankirtana, to the Kartal, Mridanga, and they come over. And they hear the hearing. When one hears very sincerely, and the words from the sincere devotee also. So that is what verse does miracle. Mataji, it is when Prabhupada can do so many wonders in US. This is also not a. It can work. It does work. And
thank
as
you,
far as, this curbs on eating non-veg or other things, these things actually become automatically. I mean, when people come with faith in the congregation, hearing about the Nam Sankirtana, and when they get association and continuously they attend the programs, these things come automatically, naturally. I mean, one need not struggle to leave fish or to leave non-veg or anything like that. There's absolutely not. This is our, what I can say, is misunderstanding, that we have to preach them to leave non-veg. We have to tell them that don't eat this, don't do that, don't do nothing, absolutely nothing. When we are preaching, we need not tell them what not to do. We have to tell them what to do. We have to tell them, you just chant. You come to our program, hear and just chant. By hearing and chanting, slowly the cleanliness takes place. Seto darpana marjanam. And then these anarthas go automatically. They themselves feel that, I should not eat this fish. But when one hears of Matsya Purana, Matsya Katha, he immediately realizes, Krishna, again, fish is, Krishna is fish. So I should not eat Krishna. So this automatically happens. But what we do is we make a mistake of telling them that you should not take non-veg, you should not drink, you should not smoke cigarettes, or we should not tell them at all. In the first beginning, in the first stage, when we are doing preaching, we have to tell them just chant Krishna, and nothing else. You do whatever you are doing in regular process, I am not interfering into that. You do, but you chant Krishna. And that is what the makes wonders.
Yes, Prabhuji, very helpful. Thank you very much.
Yes, Mataji. Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Dandat Pranam, Tulu Prabhupada, Srila Gurudev Ki Ji, very, very inspiring class. Especially all the Vaishnav songs sing very nicely. Hare Krishna Mahamantra, Hare Dandat Pranam.
Thank you, Mataji. Thank you. So, if there are no suggestions or no questions, can we stop here?
Yeah, yes, Prabhuji, but I have a request. Can you sing the Shavatara Stotra?
like all 10 verses.
All 10 verses now?
Yeah. Because we want to hear.
Oh, yes. If you have time, I can. If the time permits, I can.
Prabhu, we have time. Do you have time to sing, Prabhu?
Yeah. We will sing. Yes. Thank you. Just a minute, let me open the Vaishnav song. Ramya. So if everybody opens, if you have this Vaishnav song book in your mobile, or you go for the Pralaya Payodhi Jale, P in the index. And would you like to follow me? Or we'll take it one stretch?
No, Prabhuji, just you sing, because
at
it will
stretch.
Be... Like,
then it will stretch, okay.
Pralaya Payodhi Jale Dhritavanasi Vedam Vihita Vahitra Charitramakhedam Keshavadhrita Meena Sharira Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Ha Jai Jagadish Hare.
That was the first avatar.
Kshitiriha Vipulatare Tishthati Tava Prishthe Dharani Dharana Kina Chakra Garishthe Dharani Dharana Kina Chakra Garishthe Keshavadhrita Kurma Sharira Keshavadhrita Kurma Sharira Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare.
That was second avatar, Kurma.
Vasati Dashana Shikhare Dharani Tava Lagna Shashini Kalanka Kaleva Nimagna Shashini Kalanka Kaleva Nimagna Keshavadhrita Sukara Rupa Keshavadhrita Sukara Rupa Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare.
That was third, Sukara Rupa.
Tavakara Kamala Vare Nakham Adbhuta Shringa Dalita Hiranya Kashiputanu Bhringa Dalita Hiranya Kashiputanu Bhringa Keshavadhrita Narahari Rupa Keshavadhrita Narahari Rupa Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare.
This was fourth avatar, Narsingadev, which I deliberately missed, skipped, because we always chant Narsingadev's mantra.
But I would request you all to chant Narasimha Mantra nowadays more. Fifth avatar was Vamana Deva.
Chalayasi Vikramane Balim Adbhuta Vaman Padana Kanir Janita Jana Pavan Padana Kanir Janita Jana Pavan Keshavadrita Vamana Rupa Keshavadrita Vamana Rupa Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare.
Now it is Parshurama.
Kshatriya Rudhiramaye Jagadapagata Papam Snapayasi Payasi Shamita Bhavatapam Snapayasi Payasi Shamita Bhavatapam Keshavadrita Bhrigupati Rupa Keshavadrita Bhrigupati Rupa Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare.
Seventh was Prabhu Ramachandra.
Vitarasi Dekshurane Dikpati Kamaniyam Dashamukha Mauli Balim Ramaniyam Keshavadrita Ramasharira Keshavadrita Ramasharira Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare.
And next is Haladhara, that is Baladeva.
Vahati Vapushi Vishade Vasanam Jaladabham Halahati Bhiti Nilitayamunabham Halahati Bhiti Nilitayamunabham Keshavadrita Haladhara Rupa Keshavadrita Haladhara Rupa Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare.
Now is Buddha, the ninth one.
Nindasi Yajna Vidher Ahasuha Shuti Jatam Sadaya Hrdaya Darshita Pashugatam Sadaya Hrdaya Darshita Pashugatam Keshavadrita Buddha Sharira Keshavadrita Buddha Sharira Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare.
And tenth one is Kalki Avatara.
Mlechani Vahani Dhane Kalayasi Karavalam Dhumaketum Iva Kimapi Karalam Dhumaketum Iva Kimapi Karalam Keshavadrita Kalki Sharira Keshavadrita Kalki Sharira Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare Jai Jagadish Hare.
And then Jaidev Goswami concludes.
Sri Jaya Deva Kaveri Damudita Mudaram ಶೃಣು ಸುಖದಂ ಶುಭದಂ ಭವಸಾರಂ ಶೃಣು ಸುಖದಂ ಶುಭದಂ ಭವಸಾರಂ ಕೇಶವದ್ರೀತ ದಾಸವಿಧರು ದಶವಿಧ ರೂಪ ಕೇಶವಧ್ರೇತ ದಶವಿಧ ರೂಪ ಜಯ ಜಗದೀಶ ಹರೇ ಜಯ ಜಗದೀಶ ಹರೇ ಜಯ ಜಗದೀಶ ಹರೇ ಜಯ ಜಗದೀಶ ಹರೇ
ವೇದಾನುದ್ಧರತೆ ಜಗಂತಿ ವಹತೆ ಭೂಗೋಲಂ ಉದ್ಭಿದ್ರತೆ ದೈತ್ಯಂ ಧಾರಯತೆ ಬಲಿಂ ಛಲಯತೆ ಕ್ಷತ್ರಕ್ಷಯಂ ಕುರುವತೆ ಪೌಲಸ್ಯಂ ಜಯತೆ ಹಲಂ ಕಲಯತೆ ಕಾರುಣ್ಯಂ ಆತನ್ವತೆ ಮ್ಲೇಚ್ಛಾನ್ ಮೂರ್ಛಯತೆ ದಶಕೃತಿ ಕೃತೆ ಕೃಷ್ಣಾಯ ತುಭ್ಯಂ ನಮಃ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್.
ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರಿ ಬೋಲ್ ಜಯ ಜಯ ಹರಿ ಬೋಲ್
ಜಯ ಆಲ್ ಗ್ಲೋರೀಸ್ ಟು ದಿ
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್
ಶ್ರೀಮದ್ ಗ್ರಂಥ ಶ್ರೀಮದ್ ಭಾಗವತಂ ಕಿ ಜಯ ಶ್ರೀಲ ಪ್ರಭುಪಾದ ಕಿ ಜಯ ಶ್ರೀಲ ಗುರುದೇವ ಕಿ ಜಯ ವಿ
ವಿಲ್ ಆಫರ್ ಪ್ರಭು ಟು ದಿ
ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ವಾಂಚಂ ಕಲ್ಸರ್ ವಿಶ್ವ ಕಪಾಸ್ ಸಂದೇಶ ಪಾವನೆ ದೇವ ವೈಷ್ಣವ ದಿನಮೋ ನಮಃ
ನಮಃ
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ಜಯ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಆಲ್
ಜಯ
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್
ಹರಿ
ಬೋಲ್
ಹರಿ ಕೃಷ್ಣ
ದಂಡ ಪ್ರಣಾಮ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು
ಪ್ರಭುಜಿ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಪ್ರಭುಜಿ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ.